Charles, thanks so much for being here. What I'd like to talk about is transformative leadership, HR transformative leadership, and I know you have a strong opinion on that. Mm-hmm. When you talk about transformative leaders in HR, what should a transformative leader look like?
I moved to HR 10 years ago. When I moved to HR, I asked my team, no clue about HR, I said, what would make you proud of working for the function? Can you describe me what it is? Because if you understand what makes people proud, then it's very easy to move them to the next level. Okay. And the answer I got was, our dream will be to have a seat at the table. And I said, sorry? Can you explain what is this table about? He said, well, we're talking about the people table. So I look at, and I said, you want a seat at your own table? That's what you are saying here. So let me make sure that I understand what you say. So it's like, if I will invite you home, I will cook for you. I will go shopping. I will cook for you. I will sit you all around the table in my house. And I will ask you the question, by the way, can I sit to my table? Okay. So what I'm trying to say here, we have to move from having a seat at the table to owning the table. I'm not in the business of having a seat at any table. I'm in the business of owning the people agenda and deciding who I want to sit around the table. So what I'm trying to say, Eric, is it's all about the mindset. It's not about, you know, we can talk about behaviors, we can talk about inspiration. Leadership in HR is not very different than what you will need in other functions. But I think what's need to change in HR, if we want to play the role that we need to play, and it's a need. The world is changing, okay? The workforce is changing. Aspirations are changing. Expectations are changing. So the role of HR in shaping this new world is absolutely critical. But we'll only get there if we clearly understand this is our table and we lead the conversation at that table.
So I'm curious to know, because you probably have colleagues or people working at other companies that have, you know, a pure background in HR.
Yeah.
What do you think is the biggest difference between you coming from a commercial background and someone who's been in HR for a long time?
Okay.
When you talk about leadership.
First, there is no one good way of being an HR professional. Okay. You can absolutely study HR all your life and be a great HR professional. You can come from line, be a great HR professional. So I just want us to make sure that there is no perfect solution. If you come from line, you will be good HR. If you don't come from line, you will be a bad HR. Okay? Because as I say, it's all about the mindset you have into that one. I think that having said that, and being a true believer in diversity, I think you need a combination of both. I think what I bring to the table is empathy with the business, because I've been doing those jobs. I've been in marketing, I've been in sales, I've been in finance. So it's easier for me to understand what that means for people being in those functions. Okay, so let me give you an example. When you deal with someone of corporate affairs, which is very important for a company, and this person is facing a massive crisis in terms of tax increase and all of that, the fact that I went through that myself, I can understand exactly what the person is facing in terms of emotions, in terms of needs, in terms of stress. So it's easy for me to have a conversation with that person. Okay, it's just about empathy. Now, I can discuss with that person, but if I don't have the tools and the solution to provide to that person in order to deal with the situation, it won't work. So that one is a combination of very strong HR professional who have the tool, the skills, the knowledge, and my empathy from the business. And when you combine them both together, not only one, then you can have a very strong HR functions.
Yeah, so you're saying on the one hand, empathy and really understanding the business, so understanding what the business is about.
Yes.
And on the other hand, having the HR skill set that you need in order to deliver superior HR support to create that business value.
Absolutely. When I was appointed to HR for the first time, my first decision was to hire a head of OE or effectiveness, because I knew that I have no knowledge about the functions, okay? And HR is not common sense, okay? So you have too many people that believe, including online CEOs and leaders, that believe that HR is common sense. I'm sorry, this is a function same as finance, same as marketing, same as sales, and there's some technical knowledge you need to have. And when you don't have this knowledge, which was my case, and I'm not saying I have it right now, but after 10 years, I have probably better understanding, you need to surround yourself with deep experts that can really advise you on how to do stuff. Okay, and that I think this is this combination we're looking for.
Yeah, so the HR transformative leader of the future has on the one hand empathy, understands the business, understands what's going on. On the other hand, has the skills, or at least the network, knows how to deliver HR in a superior way, and then can connect that to business value.
Yes, and what I would say as well is, in addition to what we discussed, is when I say understanding the business, it's not on being superficial about it. Okay, I can see sometimes some people in HR saying, well, you know, they can give you the number of share of market, the number of volume, the return on investment. This is not what I mean by that. Everybody can understand that. I mean, you know, you take a financial report, you read them, you repeat them, you have it. This is really putting yourself in the shoes of the person facing consumer or customers. Okay, and how you put yourself in his, her or his shoes to really understand what that person is facing and what type of support that person will need. I think this is what is absolutely critical when we say business understanding. Okay, yeah. This is much more than the numbers.
No, that's interesting. And I think a lot of HR professionals are already struggling with the basic numbers, let alone getting that really deep understanding that you're talking about. So
I wouldn't be that negative about it. You know, I mean,
it's, I'm not saying all, some of it. I think that's a very interesting perspective, Charles.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.